We thank Christina there and here from Catfishing to the Hardwood. It's Neve Schulman. The morning news essentially is more responsible for Dancing with the Stars than Dancing with the Stars itself. Neve, I don't know if you saw our show yesterday morning, but Rashad Jennings was on the show, and he handicapped how he thought you would be doing. Watch this.
I tell you what, there's some standout people. I've been surprised the most at Neve, though. He's because I had a chance to do Catfish. I was on Catfish with him. I co-hosted, and you know, we found the liar, and we found the catfish themselves. But he shocked me. Like, if you would have told me he could move, I would have said no way.
All right, what an endorsement! Go, and then what happened? Look at this.
You want to see this thing turn into a real
hero? Did he come over to your house, or what went on?
Yeah, I was texting with him actually when he did his interview with you yesterday, and I said, "Well, you know what? Come on over because you won the mirror ball. So if you train me, it'll only help me win the mirror ball." So he just popped over.
Wow! All right, you tell me. I suspect the way Rashad, of course, who has won the mirror ball, felt. You have surprised a lot of people. I don't think people knew that you would be this adept. Did you know?
Well, I grew up very fortunate. I was sort of surrounded by the performing arts. My parents were big fans of dance. I got to go to a lot of dance. And actually, as an angsty young kid, the first time I ever really felt like I found an outlet for all of my energy and a place where I could excel was as part of the dance organization, National Dance Institute, which finds, you know, inner city youth and gives them an opportunity to express themselves through movement. And so while I wasn't trained professionally and I never pursued a career as a dancer, I did have experience performing. And my love of dance continued through my adult life. And so I've always thought of myself as a, you know, decent dancer, but never really been given an opportunity to see how I would do in this type of setting. So it has surprised me, but it has felt also in a weird way like a long time coming.
Well, I tell you what, I think it's something, maybe it's like swimming or bicycle, where if you are taught young, you don't forget. We're going to show a little bit of you in full here. Neve doing incredibly well on Dancing with the Stars. Look. When you look at that tape, are you surprised it's you?
I mean, look, here I am. I can't help myself.
Right.
It is. You know, that was really fun to get to be Captain Jack Sparrow and do all the crazy moves. In fact, I still now, 2 days later, can't fully get the eyeliner off. But it is so much fun. The show is such a welcome distraction and relief from all the... Well, otherwise bad news that we've all been dealing with for so many months now. So just get to go out there, have fun, smile, and hopefully bring some smiles to people watching has been a real treat.
Well, you're doing a really good job. I suspect, Neve, the endorsement offers from Gillette and Schick are going to come fast and furious. You're the hairiest man anyone's ever seen on television.
I am happy to be representing the millions of men around the world who perhaps haven't been able to fully express themselves via their body hair. So for all hairy men everywhere, just know that I'm out here working for you.
Well done. Thanks, Neve. You can catch him with Dancing with the Stars Monday nights on ABC. Well said. He represented the hairy community very well. Of course, he also is the host of the MTV show Catfish. We'll go back to you guys.
All right, Sam. Thank you.